Banff was first settled in the 1880s when the Canadian Pacific Railway traveled through the area. In 1883, three Canadian Pacific Railway workers stumbled upon the natural hot springs beside Sulphur Mountain. The workers built a cabin in the vicinity and began to develop the area. In 1885, Prime Minister John A. Macdonald created the Banff Hot Springs Reserve, which over the years grew into the Banff National Park, Canada's first national park. The development and commercialization began almost immediately after the discovery of the hot springs. The famous Banff Springs Hotel was constructed in 1888 and became the luxurious lodging of wealthy tourists, celebrities, and public officials alike. Today, Banff is home to one of the world's best golf courses, hiking, camping, ski resorts, and the town of Banff, including the commercial area of Banff Avenue. The struggle between the natural beauty of Banff and development started years ago, but the struggle still continues today. Today, Banff sits at approximately 7,200 permanent residents. Of those residents, 86% of them are employed, with over 65% of the employed working in sales of service or management industries. Both industries which primarily work to accompany the 3 million plus tourists which visit the park each year. With so many people passing through the national park, it is hard for officials to balance or even control the differences between the natural beauty of the park and the development of the few towns within. A group of inquisitive students travel to various destinations within Alberta to investigate the conflict between the environment and the development in Banff, and learn the points of view of various professionals. We met with people whose opinions lay on both ends of the spectrum between development and the natural beauty of the park.
I would like to see more development. I think we're still like a kind of a backwards town. I think we need to move up a step. A little bit more growth. There's housing shortages. There's no expansion.
What's really special about Banff is the fact that it's so easily accessible. I think that people are very confused about Banff. I think that people think that Banff is Banff Avenue.
Well, there is a lot of natural areas still in Banff, and I do appreciate that. I do worry that there's sometimes a overdevelopment, and so maybe they need to have, it's just my opinion, but maybe they need to have some of the areas set aside strictly for the environment. If they're as valuable and as rare as we think they are. I do love the fact that there's public access to those national parks, and I think we do need to have them, but maybe we also need to make sure that there's sites set aside for nature.
I mean, there's always the other side of the postcard where people say that there should be no development in a national park.
The town of Banff itself is a huge point source for pollution and human activities that are rough on wildlife.
I'm not a wildlife expert. I can't say where the animals go and where, we shouldn't be.
We never had bears in this area, now we do. Because of development in Banff, a lot of these creatures, animals, they follow the river and they want to find new areas that aren't inhabited because their way of life has been severely disrupted through development.
I've been here, there have been a couple of incidents where people have interacted with a grizzly bear in a way that has hurt the people. It's a struggle to keep them on the landscape, there's no doubt. But we still have all the wilderness aspects, and we have access to it.
Well, I've been watching Parks Canada since 1970. I've worked for them. I've contracted with them. I've lived in a national park town. And what I've noticed is the steady erosion of wilderness values in the national parks in preference. Well, what is preferred is tourism.
The more tourism, as far as I'm concerned, the better. The more people come to Banff and enjoy Banff. But along with that, you have to have stores, you have to have restaurants, hotels.
Well, Parks Canada is all about trying to make sure that tourism happens in a way that doesn't negatively affect the nature that people come here to enjoy. So pretty much everything we do here in the park, if you're wearing a uniform like mine, is about trying to make sure that all these people that come have great experiences of nature, and at the same time they respect nature and they do not negatively impact nature.
So I think there's been a lot of negative impact from increased tourism in Banff National Park, especially in the last 10 years. The numbers haven't gone up that much, but the emphasis on increased tourism has.
It's all, to me, it's all man-made. The nature, the spirit of the mountains, the spirit of the land is gone. What you see now is a lot of development, housing, resorts, all man-made.
As I said, the town of Banff, the footprint has been established. There is no more development. We can develop within our leasehold. There are no buildings over three stories. The Banff Springs Hotel was given that exemption because it was here before it became a national park. But no, we're limited as far as population and building.
You know, most of the park, 97% of the park, is wilderness. We still have grizzly bears. We still have as many grizzly bears as we had 20 or 30 years ago.
But the park itself is unfortunately terribly underfunded, and the commercial sector in Banff National Park is, I think, basically out of control.
I think that some people think that Banff is overdeveloped and over-commercialized. I think there's, having lived here for 30 years, I think that Banff is just a wonderful mix of accessibility and wilderness.
I think things like our national parks, our provincial parks, our museums, our art galleries, our national historic sites, they're like a memory box of Canada. They're like our collective photo album. They're the photo album of all of our memories. And therefore, it is vital that we keep those memories, that photo album, that memory box alive, so that the next generation of Canadians know who we are.